Hey guys, this is Tom from Virtual Tours Creator, and this is the ultimate guide on how to create virtual reality tours for real estate and real estate only. There is plenty of different advice on the internet, but if you are interested in real estate and real estate only, this is the tutorial that you want to see. We focus only on real estate. I've done probably 100 or more virtual reality tours myself. If you're shooting with one-click cameras, not DSLR, this is the tutorial for you. This is what you want to hear, and this is what is going to give you, I hope, all the knowledge that I have, and I hope there's not much left. So if you're ready, let's go. In this part, I will talk about lighting, camera positioning in rooms, tripod setup, lens direction, proper hotspot placement and hallway photography, stitch line, exposure and ISO. So we just walked into the house because we finished shooting outside, and the first thing we have to do is make sure all the lights are on. Absolutely turn on every possible light in the apartment or in the house, and then we can start the setup. So we're going to start with figuring out where to put the camera somewhere in the room. So the best way is to put yourself in the position of the camera and have a spin around and see where are all the entrances and exits. So in this apartment, we're going to shoot the kitchen, which is just there. You won't see it now. I'll show it to you in a second. Balcony and this hallway with two bedrooms, an office and a bathroom behind the wall. So you have to remember that you have to put the tripod on the crossroads so you can see where you're going and where you came from. Okay? This is the most important thing, because otherwise the viewers will not understand where they're going. You can't just magically jump through the wall into the bedroom. But let's start from the beginning. So let's set up the tripod first. The first advice about setting up the tripod is don't put your legs of the tripod too wide. And you will see that in a photo in a second. You should keep the legs of the tripod probably about just 1 foot or 1.5 foot wide. Then you won't see it in the photo. Once we have that set up, we can turn on the camera and shoot our first photo. So to do that, we obviously have to leave the room, and we're just gonna have to figure out which way we're gonna look. And all we have to do is just take our first photo. Let's talk about how the camera is designed, and let's talk about the stitch line. So every 360 camera usually has two lenses. Each one of them has a reach of around 190 degrees, and when they both take the photos, they overlap and they create one 360 sphere. Now, usually where they overlap, a stitch line is created. That's when those two photos join, and it tends to be a bit blurry. Okay, so we have to avoid, that's a very important thing, we have to avoid to have the edge of the camera pointing into any important point of view. Okay, so when we walked in to this apartment through the door, we will naturally be looking this way. And you would think you point the camera like that towards the front and it should be fine. Well, it would be if we wouldn't have this corridor there, because what your viewers are going to do, they're going to naturally look to the right and are going to look down the hall to see if they can go and see the bedrooms. Now, if this stitch line is pointing right in the middle of the corridor, which you can see on the photo, it's going to make a slightly blurry line in the middle of that hallway. And we want to avoid that. So to do this, we have to make sure we spin the camera just slightly so that we have the whole view from the kitchen through the dining and the hallway in one lens, in 180 degrees. And to avoid the stitch line in any important points of view, we can point it simply at the corner of this wall, and it will naturally just disappear in here. So once we've taken photo from here, that's our first shot, we're going to move on and we're going to take the photos of the other rooms. Now, before we do that, I want to emphasize a very, very important thing about virtual reality tours, and it's a common mistake that everyone does. Now, if you're standing where you're standing, you can't see what's at the end of this hallway. And we have an office, we have a kids' room, we have a bedroom, and we also have a toilet and a bathroom over here. Now, what people tend to do is take only one photo from where the camera is standing now, and then you put the hotspots in here, and two over there. Now, what you don't think about is that if you're gonna open it on your mobile phone, the view is gonna get so narrow that those hotspots are gonna sit on top of each other. That's one problem, and we want to avoid that just by having one hotspot at the end of this corridor in here, which is gonna allow us to look inside of those rooms and see what's there. So what we have to do is simply take the camera, put it somewhere in the middle here, so that when we open our preview of the camera on our mobile phone, we're gonna be able to see what's inside of every of those rooms. And also, we have to see where the camera was standing previously. So remember, have to see where you came from and where you're going. Now, the simplest solution or explanation to that is, think if you were to take those photos and send them to somebody in your office to do the tour for you, upload it for you, but they have never been in this house. So they don't know that there's an office here or which bedroom is where, okay? And they will not be able to put the tour together. But if you're gonna put the camera here, from this photo, you're gonna have some points of references. So you'll see that in the office, you have a chair and a computer, you have a tent in the kids' house, and you have a big bed in the main bedroom. So remember, always take a photo on crossroads, as I said, with the ability to see what's inside of every room. And even now, standing here, we can't really see where the bathroom is. So the next photo that we're gonna have to take after this one, we're gonna have to move this tripod only 1 meter to the right, just 1 meter, one extra photo. You might think, oh, let's not do it. You know, why would you waste your time? You have to remember that the buyers have to understand the flow of the house. And if you're gonna start magically jumping through walls or ceilings, they will not understand the house. And the virtual tour is not gonna be as awesome as it should be. And they may not be interested in coming to the open house because they will not understand this house. Okay? So let's take one photo from here. We now jumped to our first room, which is the office. So in here, for the first time, I'm gonna show you how to play with exposure on the in the app, whether it's the orange or black camera, it doesn't matter. The setting is in the same spot. But first of all, what we have to do is again start with finding out where the stitching of the camera is pointing. And I will show you on the photos in a second that when the stitching of the camera is pointing slightly onto that wall, you'll be able to see a little line on this wall. And I'll show you how to get rid of it. Sometimes it's as simple as putting the camera directly underneath the lights or pointing the edge of the camera to the strongest source of light, which would be the window. But sometimes it simply doesn't work and the line is there. You will see this line because I'm telling you about it. Your viewers or the buyers will probably never figure it out. They will think it's a shadow. But I want those tools to be perfect, so I'll show you how to hide it. Now the cameras are pointing slightly into the one third of this wall, and on the photo you can see that there's a line. Now, to get rid of that line or to hide it, all we have to do is spin the camera slightly and point it right into the corner of this room. And then it creates a natural crease and the line disappears. It's as easy as that, and you can do it in any other location. This is gonna be our first lesson on adjusting the exposure. in your preview. We are still in the office, and this is our live preview in 360 of what the camera can see. And as you can see over here, the windows are slightly blown out, and sometimes the room is a bit dark or too bright. So all you have to do is find this option up here on top, here those three little sliders. You open it up and it shows you all the different adjustments that you have. The ISO, and that should always be set up to about 50. And then these two triangles, black and white, plus and minus, this is exposure. And with the exposure, you can just simply slide your finger. It's usually on zero. And to darken up the room a bit, as you can see, the window is really blown up. So you turn it down to, let's say, -1. And it's gonna give you a live preview of how the room darkens. Did you just see what happened? Now, you can also crank it up to +2 and brighten up the room. That's just some extreme numbers, but just to give you an idea where the exposure is. In here, we probably get away with just a 0. One very important thing to remember is that exposure setting never ever sets itself back to 0 after you turn off the camera. It stays to whatever you set it up to. So if you happen to take some photos outside and you will want to dim down the sun a bit and you're gonna go to -2, when you walk back inside, remember to bring it back to 0, because then the whole house is gonna be way too dark or way too bright.